Hello, this is Om Prakash Yadav. So today I am going to solve one more problem on rotary balancing in different plane. So I have taken one problem. Another problem today I am going to solve. So this problem I have taken from IAS 2009. That was asked for 20 marks. And a similar kind of question are also coming in university examination or in IES conventional examination. Okay, so I want to cover today a very good variety of question. That question is really very good, very excellent question. Each and everything they have asked in a single question. So this is mixed variety. So one mass is unknown, their angular position is unknown, and also the position of the plane are unknown. Some is known and some is unknown. So this is the mixed variety. From there, you can understand a lot of good things. So this question is a really good question. It is somewhat this is tough, but you will be able to understand. Don't worry. Let us start. You can take the snapshot of this question. So, okay, don't worry. I am reading this question. Okay, so I am reading and writing the data. Here I am presenting the relative position of their plane. This is the plane A, plane B, plane C, plane D. And this is the angular position of their masses. Let us read the question. A shaft carry four rotating masses. There is a shaft on which there is a four masses. A, B, C and D in sequence along its axis. So A, B, C and D, A, B, C and D, four masses. Say this is MA, MB, MC and MD. The masses A, B, C and D are assumed to be concentrated at the radius of 12 cm, 16 cm, 8 cm and 10 cm. So their radius of rotation RA, RB, RC and RD is given. So in this calculation table, I have written their radius in meter. For 1.12, for B this is 0.16, for C this is 0.08 and for D this is 0.10 meter. So I have converted centimeter into meter. So radius of rotation of all the four masses is given, that is tabulated here. Respectively, the masses of B, C and D are, the masses of B, C and D, that is MB, MC and MD is given, which is 30 kg, 50 kg and 40 kg. So you can see here A, B, C, D. So B, C, D are 30, 50 and 40 kg. This mass of A is unknown. So I have written MA. The plane containing B and C are 30 cm apart. So plane containing mass B and C are 30 cm apart, so in meter will be 0.3 meter. Look at here. So distance between B and C is 0.3 meter. This is 0.3 meter. That is only given and the other distance is not given. Now, the angular spacing of the plane containing C and D, are 90 degree and 210 degree respectively, relative to be measured in same sense. Means either you have to take in counterclockwise direction or you have to take in clockwise direction, but both you have to take in the same sense. So I have taken counterclockwise. So let us assume that mass B is along the positive x axis. So from B, mass C is at an angle of 90 degree. This is mass C, and from B in the same sense, mass D is at an angle of 210 degree. Look at here. So, I have assumed that position of mass B along the positive x-axis, then position of mass C is along this and the position of mass D is along this, and angular position of mass A is not given. Angular position of mass A is not given. That has to be calculated. Okay, in the same sense, so I have taken in counterclockwise direction. Also, this can be taken in clockwise direction. That is also possible, but I have taken this one. Their sense should be same. That is either clockwise or counterclockwise. So I have taken counterclockwise. Counterclockwise. Now, what he is saying that there is a system of masses, four system of masses A, B, C, D. Now, look at, if the system is to be in complete dynamic balance,
means the system of masses A, B, C, D to be in complete dynamic balance. Complete balance means static and dynamic both balancing. So for the complete balancing, find number one, the mass and angular position of mass A. So what is the mass in the plane A? That is ma. You have to calculate. And the angular position of mass A is not given, also you have to calculate the angular position of mass A. That is the first question. Now second question is that spacing position of the plane containing A and D. So BC, distance between B and C is 0.3 meter and relative position of mass A and mass B, your plane A and place D is not given. He is saying that you have to calculate. So let us see that I have taken in sequence. Whatever will be, I will get. Don't worry. So just I have taken in a sequence A, B, C, D. Let us assume that the distance of plane A from B is at a distance of x, and the distance from the B to the plane of D is y. So this plane in the mass D is at a distance of y from the plane of mass B. Let us assume this is x and this is y. So now you can see that distance, you can measure each and every distance in the term of x, y and this 0.3 meter. Okay, so you have to calculate what is x, what is y. So what you have to calculate, what is the mass ma, what is the angular position of mass ma, what is the distance x, what is the distance y. That should be right or that should be left. You will get with the sign. You will get with the sign. If x and y will be plus, means their relative position will be exactly same as what I have taken. If you are getting x negative, means x is not left to b, but this is what right to a. If you are getting y is negative, then this d will be not right to b, but that will be left to b. So whatever things will come, I will see later on. Okay, so that is our problem. Again, I am elaborating. So there are four system of masses in plane A, B, C and D. MA, MB, MC, MD at a radius of RA, RB, RC, RD. Mass of BCD is given. All the radius of rotation are given. And this system of masses are in a complete balance. Then you have to find out the unknown value. Okay, now let us do the calculation in tabular form. So we are doing the calculation in this tabular form. So here I am writing plane. So plane, let us see, start from left to right. So this plane are A, B, C, D. So A, B, C, D. Okay. So I am not taking the balancing mass because they are saying that these four system of masses to be completely balanced. So there is no need to take the balancing masses. Okay. So A, B, C, D, their mass are, this is known. So I have taken it as MA. In BCD, this is 30, 50 and 40 kilogram. The radius of rotation is given 12, 16, 8 and 10 centimeter. So in meter will be this one. Now, this is M into R. So MR omega, actually the centrifugal force is MR omega is square. So omega is common. So I am leaving from all the analysis. So actually this is what FC MR omega is square. Buttock omega is square. So FC buttock omega is square. So from here we will draw the first polygon. So let us find out M into R. Means multiply this to both the column. So 0.1 to MA. This will be 4.8. This will be 4.0. And this is 4.0. Now, you take the reference plane. Look it here. I have taken reference plane in the plane of B, not in the plane of A. Why? Why? Because the unknown is only in the plane A. If I will take this as a reference plane, this MA, this one will be zero. So you will not be able to calculate it. So let us take this B as a reference plane. So distance right to B will be positive and left to this will be negative. Negative. So distance of the plane from the reference plane is L. Distance of the plane from the reference plane. So for A, this is left to B, so this distance is x, so that will be minus x. For B, this is itself here, so distance will be 0. For C, this is at a distance of 0.3 meter, so this is 0.3 meter. And D is at a distance of y, so this is what, plus y. So this is the distance of plane from the reference plane RP. Now, let us find out the couple just by multiplying these two columns. So m into r into l. So that is mRL. So let us multiply this and put it here. So this is 0, you will get 0. This you will get 1.2. Multiplication of this and this, you will get 4 watt. So this is the table in which we are putting the data and the calculating. So this is your calculation table. Okay. Now from here we are drawing the first polygon, and from here we are drawing the couple polygon. Okay. Now let us see that which diagram should be drawn first. This depends upon what, that how many number of unknown are there. So look at here. In this first polygon, these three are known completely in magnitude and direction. BCD, direction of BCD is known, and their magnitude is also known. So these three are completely known. Only this is unknown, and this is unknown in magnitude and direction both. So there are one unknown at one places. Look at in the couple polygons. So you are looking that this 4y and this one, this both are unknown. So unknown is at two places. In first polygon, unknown is only at one places. So you have to draw first polygon. First you draw the first polygon, get the magnitude of MA and the direction of MA. Then you draw the couple polygon to get the X and Y. So let us start and draw the first polygon. Draw the first polygon first. I have elaborated that why I am going to draw the first polygon. First polygon. So first of all, you have to take some suitable scale. Take some suitable scale. I have solved this problem completely. So whatever scale I have taken, I am going to take, but you can take as per your convenience. So for the first polygon, I have taken 1 kg meter. 1 kg meter is equal to 1 centimeter. 1 kg meter is equal to 1 centimeter. Means what? I have taken 1:1 scale. So this will be 4.8 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 4 centimeter. Let us start and draw the first polygon. Draw the first polygon. So let us start. This is the unknown. So leave that. Then B. So this bar, this B is here. So what will be direction of 4.8? This will be radially outward, because centrifugal force is radially outward. So I am drawing here first. For the plane B, this is 4.8, so draw 4.8 centimeter line. Suppose this is 4.8 and this is O, this is A, this is O, this is A. Any scale you have to draw this 4.8 centimeter in the direction of B, radially outward, because centrifugal force is radially outward. Now next is in the plane of C, so mass C is along this direction. And it is 4. So now from the head of this vector, let us draw the force in plane C, along MC. So that is 4.0. So this is what in this direction. So this is a 4.0. Let us say that this is B. This is B. Then in the plane D, the force is 4.0, and you know that what is the direction of D. So D is along that. So from the head of this vector, let us draw the third one. So this is what? 4. This is 4. So this is somewhat this. This is again 4.0, and say this is C. Now you have drawn this 1, 2, 3. And this one is remaining. So closing side will be the unknown. Closing side will be the unknown. So this is the unknown. Then this closing side will be the unknown. So this closing side will be the unknown. So this is what? 0.12 ma. So this is a 0.12 ma, 0.12 ma. So how to calculate this magnitude? So this 0.12 ma is equal to this OC into scale. This OC into scale.
So this 0.12 MA by measurement, what I have got. So in my scale, what I have got? I have got 2.4. So this 2.4 centimeter and 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kg meter. So scale is 1:1. Then from this you are getting MA is equal to 20 kg. So you are getting MA is equal to 20 kg. Look at here. So you have got magnitude of mass in the plane A, and also you have got the direction in which direction is mass A. So mass A is along CO. So draw a line here, but parallel to CO, that will be the direction, angular position of mass A. So when you draw, you are getting in this direction. So you have got the magnitude of mass M, and also you have got the direction. When you measure, you will get this angle is equal to 238 degree. By the measurement, you can got that what is the angle this. So this you will get 238 degree. So you have got what is the magnitude of mass MA, and also you have got what is the angular position of mass MA. So all the masses is now known, all the angular position of masses is known, only the relative position of plane are unknown. That can be find out from the couple polygon. So let us go and draw the couple polygon. So now I am going to draw the couple polygon. So just by phasing the video and just by repeating so many times, you can understand actually what is this. So just I am moving. So by going back and forward, you can see that solution. And by phasing, you can understand. You can take some time. Now I am going to draw the couple polygon. Again you take a suitable scale. So what scale I have taken? I have taken 0.6 kg meter square is equal to 1 centimeter. I have taken 0.6 kg meter square is equal to 1 centimeter. You can take your own scale while drawing. So you are free to take your scale, but that should be convenient scale, that your diagram should not be very small or your diagram should not be very large. Now this is very conceptual to draw it. Before drawing, let us see that you have calculated this mass MA. MA is equal to 20 kg. You put it here, 20.12 into MA, or you put the value of MA here. When you put the value of MA, you will get this is equal to minus 2.4 years. When you put the value of MA here, you will get, because you have got it, so you will get minus 2.4 years. So unknown is at the two places, still unknown is at the two places. Only this is zero and this is known, completely magnitude and direction, and this both are unknown. Let us draw the couple polygon. So first let us draw which is completely known. So this is completely known. Look at here, couple in the plane of C will be along this, radially outward. If that is plus, that will be radially outward. If that is negative, that will be radially inward. So this 1.2 will be radially outward, that is upward. So let us say this is O, then this will be A dash. This is what, 1.2. So any scale, in this scale, that will be 2 centimeter. What scale you have taken? So draw 2 centimeter vertical line. So that is what, 1.2. Now let us see that next vector will be drawn from the head of this vector. So there are two vectors, these both are unknown, so you have to draw this both. But you look at here, this direction of this is along this, so another vector will be drawn from here, from the head of this vector. So something like that, one will be something like that, then third one, look at here. So
one will be like that, another will be like that. But let us see that their coupled polygons shouldn't be close. Then that will be in complete dynamic balancing. That couple should be close. Look at here, the slope of A is more and the slope of D is less. So this line are like that. This line are like that. So let us see that from the head of this vector, who will go? Either D will go or the A will go. So you can see that if the A will go, D will be above this point and this coupled polygon will not be closed. Iska matlab kya hua? अगर A को आप यहां से ड्रॉ करते हो तो D ऊपर आएगा, फोर्स कपल पॉलीगन क्लोज ही नहीं होगा, तो बैलेंस ही नहीं होगा. अगर आप D को यहां पे लेके जाते हो तो A को यहां से जाने का चांस बनता है. तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ, यहां से पे आपका D ड्रॉ होगा, फिर A यहां से आएगा. मीन्स यू हैव टू ड्रॉ D फ्रॉम हियर. सो D विल बी फ्रॉम हियर एंड A विल बी फ्रॉम हियर. सो ड्रॉ फ्रॉम हियर, वेयर इज फॉर D, दिस इज फॉर Y. This is 4y, means you don't know the magnitude, but you know the direction of point D. So D will be along that. So draw a line parallel to this line. So this is the line which is parallel to this line. Look at here, you don't know the magnitude, only you know that direction. Their direction will be parallel to this D line. So draw a line parallel to this. So this is the second vector. This is what? 4y. 4y. What is the magnitude? I don't know, because this y is unknown. Then third vector should pass from the tail of first vector. Then the coupled polygon will be closed and the system of masses will be completely balanced. So to pass this, draw a line from O but parallel to this plane of mass A. So along parallel to this line, you draw a line from O. And this line will cut this here. So where they are cutting, that is the another point. Let us join this. Look at here. If the direction of this is in this direction, so direction of this arrow should be this, and the direction of this should be this. Then you are getting a clockwise triangle. Direction of arrow should be in the same direction. So that should be for the complete balancing. This force polygon is now closed. Arrow, if this is in this direction, that should be in this direction, and this should be in this direction for the complete balancing from the coupled polygon law. Okay, so that should be like that for the complete balancing. So this is what for MA. For MA, this is minus 2.4 R. So this is 2.4 R. Just I am writing the magnitude. Now let us see the direction. So for the complete balancing, direction should be like that. ऐसा होना चाहिए direction complete balancing के लिए. लेकिन ये 4y, 4y आपका अगर plus है, तो as per this rule, if 4y is plus, then that should be along that. But for the complete balancing, its direction should be in this direction. Means this is 4y. Because that should be in this direction, but for the balancing, the direction is in this direction, opposite to that. So this will be minus 4y. Look at here now. This is minus 2.4x. So what is the direction of A? This. So direction of this minus 2.4x should be along this direction. But you are looking that this is again opposite to that. What should be? जो होना चाहिए इधर, क्योंकि माइनस है तो इधर होना चाहिए, लेकिन किधर है? इधर है. सो अगेन दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज अ माइनस, सो दिस इज माइनस 2.4 R. सो दिस इज माइनस 4y, दिस इज माइनस 2.4 R. व्हाई दिस इज माइनस? बिकॉज व्हाट शुड बी एंड व्हाट दे आर, क्या होना चाहिए और क्या है, बेस्ड अपॉन दैट, दैट इज माइनस 4y एंड दिस इज अ माइनस 2.4 R. So this is your coupled polygon. So let us say that this is a B dash. This is the B dash. Now you can calculate what is 4x, what is your 4y. Let us see how to calculate this. By measurement you can get this one. So this minus 4y is equal to a dash b dash into scale So this minus 4y a dash b dash what I have got 2.35 centimeter and 1 centimeter is equal to 0.6. 1 centimeter is equal to 0.6 kg meter square. So just I am putting the scale. So from this you can get that what is the value of y. This is a minus 0.35 3525 meter are in centimeter. This will be minus not in centimeter, in yum that will be 352.5 yum in meter. 0.3525 meter you are getting, in centimeter, in yum you will get 352.5, and this is minus. That is the value of y. Let us you remember this, how to calculate this yucks. So this minus 2.4 yucks is equal to O B dash. This is what O B dash into scale. So this minus 2.4 yucks is equal to O B dash. What I have got in this scale? 0.3.8. I have got this 3.8 into scale is 0.6. So I am getting x is equal to minus 0.95 meter. In centimeter, this will be minus 950 yum. So that is the answer of x and y. But let us see what does mean by this negative x and negative y. Iska matlab kya? Negative x or negative y ka matlab kya? Isko samajhte hain. What is the meaning of this negative x? So by calculation, I have got this x as negative, means plane A is not left to the reference plane, but that is what right to the reference plane. That is the actual scenario. This y is negative means what? I have taken right to the reference plane, means this is not right to the reference plane. This is what left to the reference plane. That is the meaning of this negative x and negative y. So what will be the actual position of planes I am showing here? So what will be the actual position of their plane? This is a B, this is what C, and this distance is 0.3 meter, that was known. So this Y will be what left? So plane of D will be left at a distance of what? At a distance of what? 352. Y is equal to 352.5 and plane A should be right to the reference plane B at a distance of what? X, where this X is equal to this 950 yum. So that will be your answer. So actually the position of plane will be like that, means A, means this D will be left to the B and A will be left to B and C, both you have got. So in question they have told that four masses in sequence. That wording is wrong. They cannot say that they are in sequence. If they are in sequence, they cannot be balanced. So you don't mind that sentence, that these masses are in sentence, because I have taken in sentence and I have got the reverse thing. Okay, thank you very much. I will take one more problem on balancing, then each and every variety you can cover from this three problem. Okay, that person is very good question. Thank you very much.